Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can quickly create a long program out of a bunch of targets, how you can add subprogram to a main program, and how you can quickly generate a real robot program that you can load on the real controller. Let's take a look at that. So in the last video, we created a bunch of targets on top of our surface here by using the teach target on surface feature. That went honestly incredibly fast, but now we just have a bunch of targets and no program. So obviously one thing that I could do is add a program here and start adding linear motions between those targets. That's great. It would take like less than a minute, but there's a way faster way of doing that. If you select the first target, press shift and select the last target, you will select all the targets in the order they are here. You can right click on it and you can select create program. If you do so, it will automatically create a program where the first move is a move J and then all the other motions afterwards are linear motions. So as you can see, it's a very cool and quick way to create a program like this. I will rename this one inspect A, like that. My goal here is to show you how to add an approach and a retract, or in fact, how to add subprograms. And to do that, I will add an approach and a retract subprogram. Generally, I could add those directly in the main program and just go get away with just one program. But this is a pedagogical training, so I will use this as an example. So to do that, I will go back to my inspect A one point, double click the robot, move back a bit. I'm going to create a target here. I will rename it app inspect A for approach inspect A. I'm going to go to the last point, rewind a bit, just like that. Add another target, press retract inspect. Come on. Inspect A. F2 to rename. And I will create myself two subprograms. I'm going to call them app inspect A and then retract inspect A. Perfect. So now I have multiple programs. So if I want to make sure to add a motion to one specific program, I really need to select it first, press Control, and then select the target I want to add to it. In this case, app inspect A, and I will add my move J. So the first move J will bring me here. For the retract, I will do the same, select the program, select retract, and I will add a linear motion. By default, when you create a program using the right-click create program, the first move will always be a joint motion. In this case, I created a joint motion using the approach, so I don't need it. I would prefer having a linear motion here. So I'll go to this point with a joint motion, go down straight line, 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 lines, and then move back straight line. Cool. Now that I have that, I will simply bring back the robot to, let's say, the middle, somewhere around here, move up a bit, like something like this here, and I will create a new target that I will call home A, and I will switch this target from Cartesian target to joint targets, to target. I want to show you something. I'm going to create a new program called go home A, and I will add this as a joint motion. Now I need to create a main program. So I will show you what the joint mode, joint targets here, what is the impact of the joint target, in fact. So now I need to create a main program. The main program will go from go home A to app A to inspect A to retract A back to go home A. So I will create a program like that. I'm going to call it main inspect A, like that. Oops. Perfect. I will, to add subprograms, you need to go here. You have program call or insert code instruction. I'm going to select this. For now, we will stick to simple program calls. I'm going to go and select the program. So I can select go home A, click OK. And here you can see you have main inspect A with call go home A. Perfect. So now I can repeat the same process, add call here, app inspection A. If I want, I can simply press here, enter, select inspect A, click OK, enter, retract A, enter, and I can even just enter here, go home A, make sure not to do any typo, otherwise it wouldn't work. And just like that, all the program calls are added one after the other. Now I can run this program. So it will go from go home to approach, inspection, retract, go home again. And you can see here the difference in colors between the different programs. So here, this is the app, this is the inspection program, retract, and then go home. I can obviously use my slider to rotate around here like that. So that's nice. Perfect. Once you have that, you can decide to move the part around just like this. I want to show you something. So if I move the part around like that, and then I run my main again, you will see that the go home subprogram do not reach the go home position. The reason is we created a join target and not a Cartesian target. So what the priority will be placed on replicating the same joined values as we had when we teached the target. So if you have a joined target, they are not sensible to what reference frame you are using and what is the position of that reference frame. Okay, one last quick thing. If you right-click the program, you can select here Generate Robot Program or F6. And you will see in this case, the program for the UR robot in this case. So you will have all the subprograms. So go home A, app inspect A, retract inspect A. And here you'll have the main program. So go home A, app inspect A, blah, 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 go home A. And you can simply load this whole program directly into the robot controller and run it. And it should run as is. I tested it many times with the UR and it works just fine. Okay, that's everything for this video. In the next one, I'm going to show you how to use the teach target on surface for a surface that is a bit more complex or a part that is a bit more complex, where you'll have to play with the orientation of the tool, which in this case was not the case because we just went, let's say, straight. So we'll add a little level of complexity. And I have a few other tricks to show you, including how to recover from creating a bunch of targets out of the real reference frame. I hope it was helpful, and I hope to see you in the next video.